So the next step is sway analysis. So in sway analysis, as the frame is unsymmetrical, there will be sway of the frame, and then sway correction is to be applied to the above moments, that is non-sway moments, using this sway analysis. That's what we are going to do in the second step. And assume that the frame sways towards right. Okay? Just as an assumption. Therefore, the diagram will be like this. Okay? See here, this AB member, A is fixed, so there is no rotation, but B is a joint. And this delta 1 is perpendicular to AB member, remember, perpendicular to AB member, okay, this is 90 degree of course. Similarly, for CD member, this delta 2 is perpendicular CD member, okay, and D is a hinge support, therefore there will be some rotation. And joining these two, like this, maintaining the angle between BA and BC member here, here also I am maintaining angle between CD and CB here, you have to connect these two points to get the different shape of the frame. So, this is theta 1, the inclination of AB member with respect to horizontal, that is ground, theta 1. Similarly, the inclination of CD member with respect to the ground or horizontal is theta 2. So, if it is theta 1, this must be theta 1. So, this is the triangle, okay, this is a triangle, right angle, triangle. Similarly, this also right angle, triangle, this angle is theta 2. And this is delta 1, this is delta 2. Okay. As usual, the length of the member BC is not changing. Therefore, BB double dash should be equal to CC double dash. That is horizontal movement. Okay. So, this BB double dash we can get from this triangle. Similarly, CC double dash we can get from this triangle, so that we can relate delta 1 and delta 2, so that we can replace any one of the parameter unknowns. So, this is the thing we are going to do now. So, therefore, B double dash is nothing but delta 1 sin theta 1 is equal to CC double dash, which is equal to delta 2 sin theta 2. Sin theta 1 we can get from this, you know, the geometry. Similarly, sin theta 2 also we can get from the geometry. So, this is the geometry. So, AB member, the horizontal projection of AB member is 3 meter given, vertical projection of AB member is 4 meter given. So, from Pythagoras theorem, we can get the length of the member AB, that already we have done in the previous step. Similarly, CD is 4.24, 3 meter, 3 meter, therefore, we can use, that is, we can get the value of sin theta 1 and sin theta 2. So, substituting, we get delta 2 is equal to 1.13 delta 1. So, wherever we have delta 2, we can replace delta 2 by 1.13 delta 1. Okay, now we have only one extra unknown, delta 1. Similarly, the sway of BC, okay, that is the settlement of BC, delta BC is equal to the vertical component of delta 1 plus vertical component of delta 2. That means delta 1 cos theta 1 plus delta 2 cos theta 2. So, this So from this triangle we can get cos theta 1 and cos theta 2, that we have to substitute here. So finally we get delta BC is equal to 1.40 delta 1. Now we can calculate friction and moment because of this delta, sway. Okay. So in sway analysis we have to consider only this delta, not the external loads. External loads we have already done in non-sway analysis. Okay. So in this step we have to consider only the moment due to delta. So due to the delta 1 in AB, this moment is now developed at suppose 6EI delta 1 divided by L squared, here also 6EI delta 1 L squared, same sense, both at both ends we have the same sense of moment, remember. So due to delta sway, we will get the same sense of moment in all joints. So here, due to this kind of delta 1, we have anti-clockwise moment at support A as well as at support B. So this is the fixed end moment. Therefore, fixed end moment at AB is equal to fixed end moment to BA is equal to minus, because of anti-clockwise direction, minus 6EA delta 1 divided by L square. So, L is nothing but 5 meter. Therefore, 5 square is equal to 25 into EI delta 1. Similarly, for the next member, so the member BC, so this is the diagram, so this is the total displacement delta BC, okay, which support between B dash and the C dash, the new position. So here also delta BC here, and see here the support, right support is above the left support, therefore here clockwise movement is induced. Here, so 6 formula is same, but sense will be different. 6EA delta divided by L square. This is the formula always. Okay. The delta is negative, then clockwise moment will be developed. Or, in other ways, if the left support is below the right support, then the clockwise moment. If the left support is above the right support, then anti-clockwise. Okay, this we have to keep in mind. Therefore, fixed end movement at BC, FC, BBC both are equal here, clockwise movement, therefore plus, okay, is equal to 6EA delta BC divided by L square. Delta BC we have already calculated in terms of delta 1, which is equal to 1.40 delta 1. Okay, and L is nothing but meter. Therefore, 14 over 15 EI delta 1. Next, consider the next number CD. So, this is the displaced position. We have delta 2 here. Okay. So, this is the new position. The D is more below. That is, left support is above the right support. That means, we will have anti-clockwise. And because of the hinge support, there is no moment here induced here. But due to hinge, this is the formula just changes to 3EA delta divided by L square. If the support is fixed, then 6EA delta by L square. If the support is hinged, then the formula is 3EA delta by L square. Okay. Therefore, moment, fixed end moment in CD as well as in DC, but DC is 0 here, in only CD we have, is a minus because negative, therefore minus 3A delta 2 divided by L2, L square, and delta 2 we have to replace in terms of delta 1, which is equal to 1.13 delta 1, so which is equal to minus 0.189 EI delta 1. Okay. So far we have computed the fixed in the moment due to S wave or delta. But see, the moments are in terms of EI and delta 1. Okay, EI and delta 1. But for distribution table, we need numerical value. Then only we can do the process of balance and carry over. For that, we have to assume some moments. Okay, proportionately we have to assume some moments to start the distribution process. Okay, for that we will take some fraction, some ratio between any two moments. Accordingly we will assume some value. Okay, because remember this delta, we don't know the value, exact value. This is the assumed delta. We don't know exact value. So for this assumed delta, we will get the assumed moment. Non-sway moment. Okay? So considering the proportion of bending fixed end moments, that is MFAB is to MF some BC is to some MF CD is equal to minus 6 divided by 2. Okay. So EI delta 1 is cancelled. Because common we can take out. So this is the proportion, that means moment, fixed end moment in AB is of minus 6 by 25 units. Fixed end moment in BC is of plus 14 by 15 units. And fixed end moment in CD is minus 0.189 units. So in order to get some round number or whole number, we here multiply by 1000. That's why now we get the last one is 180 minus 189. Accordingly the other values. Therefore, if I multiply by 1000, okay, any value, by any value you can multiply. The target is to get some whole number, okay, not a fraction. So this will be, for example, say, moment, fixed end moment in AB is equal to minus 240, fixed end moment in BC is equal to plus 933, fixed end moment in FCD is equal to minus 189. Now we have some numerical value. It's a just assumption, assume, okay, not the exact value, but the assumed value, okay. It's just to start the distribution table, it is enough. Otherwise, we can't do the distribution process, okay. Therefore, we are doing this kind of business. So we can start the distribution table. Join the A as usual, E, B, C, D, member, distribution factor, everything same as that of non-sway analysis. Only the thing is, the changes is here, fixed end moment. So under AB, we have to put minus 240, BA also minus 240, already we have seen, okay, because fixed end moment FAB is equal to fixed end moment FBA. That's why this is minus 240, this also minus 240. And similarly, fixed moment FBC is equal to plus 933, which is equal to MFCB is equal to plus 933. Here minus CD, okay, MFCD is equal to minus 189. Here MFDC is equal to 0 because of thin support. Okay, now we have to look at the supports first. Because the remaining process is only balance and carryover. So before starting the balance step, we have to look at the supports. Whether we have any hinge support or not. Okay? You have to leave fixed support. Okay? Don't consider fixed support. You have to look for any hinge support. Okay? Yeah. In this problem, we have B support is a hinge support. And then the next one is, we have to look at, is there any movement, fixed end movement in the hinged support. Fortunately, we don't have, we have only zero movement. Therefore, no need to do anything at joint T. Suppose if we have non-zero value, first we have to balance that non-zero value. Okay, this is the first step. Okay, but in this case, no need to do that one. Because support, at support D, we have already zero. Moment is zero. That means the balance, it is balanced, already balanced. No need to rebalance. So once that process is over, we have to look at the interior joints. What are the interior joints we have? B and C. Okay. Each joint should be in equilibrium. That means at each joint, the net moment should be equal to zero. Now we will calculate. See here, because at joint B we have two members, BA and BC. For BA we have -240, for BC we have +933. So just add algebraically these two moments, then we will get some positive moment, extra positive moment. But according to equilibrium conditions, at B this should be equal to 0, net moment should be equal to 0. Therefore, the extra moment we have to make it nullified. Therefore, we have to apply the opposite moment for the same numerical value. Okay? Here also, at joint C also, we have two members CB and CD. In CB, we have +933 moments. In CD, we have -189 moments. So, adding these two algebraically, we get some extra positive moment. So, here also, we have to balance by applying just the opposite moment. Okay? In accordance with the distribution factor that we know already. So, balance step. So, positive moment is extra, therefore we are applying negative moment. Okay? Extra moment into 3 by 8 will be -259. Extra moment into 5 by 8 will be minus, like that. Okay, that you know already. So, once balance is over, all the joints are in equilibrium conditions, in balanced state. But, due to the balance step, we have to do the carryover process. So, carryover, because we have applied -259.9 to BA member, therefore the opposite side AB will get half of this moment, -130.0. Similarly, we have applied some moment in BC, therefore the opposite side CB will get half of this moment. Similarly, CB to BC, okay? That is -243.1, here -216.6. But there is no carryover from CD to BC. Okay? Because in support is hinged. Now, due to the carryover process, the joint B and joint C get disturbed by this extra moment. Okay? A joint B is disturbed by this extra amount, joint C is disturbed by this amount, extra amount. Therefore, we have to do again the balance step only for this extra moment. This is the extra moment at joint B. This is the extra moment at joint C. But here we have minus, therefore we have to apply +243.1 at joint B. At joint C, we have to apply +216.6. Okay? So, this is the balance step. So, due to the balance step, we have to carry out the carryover step. Next. So, likewise, we have to repeat till in balance step, we get only insignificant numbers. That is, for example, say 0.0 something. That time we can stop. Okay. So I think we can stop the balance because we get 0.1 something. Okay. Because no, it takes a huge, you know, so many steps. So we can stop here, and we can calculate the final moments. So this is the final moments from the sway analysis. Remember, this is just assumed. Okay, assumed sway moment, not the exact moment. So exact moment, exact sway moment will be some fraction of this moment. That we have to keep in mind. Therefore, the actual sway moments be x times. We can assume x times the moments. No, just we got from the distribution table. Therefore, the actual moment will be the moment from non-sway analysis plus this x times the moments from sway analysis. Actually, sway moment will be the assumed sway moment plus into x. Okay. So 1.0 is the non-sway moment in AB, and sway moment is minus 334.05 into x. So similarly for all other moments. So here the thing is to get the actual, the final moment, we have to get the value of x. That is, we have to solve some equation for x. That some equation is actually the shear equation. So using shear equation, we have to get the value of x and substitute back here to get the final actual moment. So consider the whole frame. Here we have to consider only horizontal forces. Okay, and horizontal external load. Because no horizontal external loads are given. We have only HA and HB. Initially we assume in the same direction, okay, acting towards right direction. So therefore, applying sigma is equal to 0, we get HA plus HD is equal to 0. So this is the shear equation. Now the next step is to find out the HA and HD in terms of joint moments. So for that we have to consider the free body diagram of each span, then we have to calculate the HA, HB. So now consider the span BC, and here see we have assumed the same sense of moment, because due to sway we will have same sense of moments at each joint. That's very important. Okay, therefore sigma MC is equal to 0 RB into 3 plus MBC plus MCB minus Y into 3 square by 2 is equal to 0. From that we get RB is equal to 7.5 minus the whole into MBC plus MCB by 3. Okay. Therefore, applying sigma V is equal to 0, we get RC value. So RC is equal to 7.5 plus MBC plus MCB divided by 3. Now we have to consider the other member. Now consider the free body diagram of AB. Here also see we have assumed all clockwise moment. Okay. This is the moment due to sway. Okay. So RB here from the PC member, and here RA, this HA, everything. So now taking moments about B, that means sigma MB is equal to 0, or first sigma V is equal to 0, because to get the value of RA, that we have to use in the sigma MP is equal to 0. Therefore, first apply sigma V is equal to 0, therefore RA is equal to
RB, because we have only two vertical forces. RA is equal to RB, which is equal to 7.5 minus MPC plus MC divided by 3. Now apply sigma MPC equal to 0. So therefore, RA into 3 plus MAB minus HA into 4 plus MBA is equal to 0. So from this expression we can get HA value in terms of joint moments. So finally we get HA expression in terms of joint moments. So next we consider the other member CD. Here also first apply sigma V is equal to 0 to get RD value, which is equal to RC, because we have only RC and RD as vertical forces and acting opposite direction. Now apply sigma MC is equal to 0. Therefore, minus RD into 3, or you can also use plus, no problem. Okay. You have to keep the sign consistently. So minus RD into 3 minus HD into 3 plus MCD, because it is acting clockwise direction, is equal to 0. Therefore HD we get in terms of joint moments. So now we have both HA and HD value, we can substitute in the shear equation. HA plus HD is equal to 0. Therefore, so this is the HA plus HD expression. So now we have to substitute MAB, MBA, MBC, MCB, M and MCD values from the previous step. Okay? That is, which is equal to MAB is equal to 1.0 minus 334.05x. So that values we have to substitute here. So this is the expression in terms of x. Now we can solve x value. Okay? Use from this expression. By simplifying, we can get x value. So this is the expression. So from this, x is equal to minus 0.00205. So here, the minus sign indicates that our assumption of sway direction is not correct. Actually, the frame sways towards the left direction. Okay? Now, the final moments we can get by substituting the value of x. So, MAB is equal to 1.0 minus 334.05 into x value minus 0.00205, so which is equal to plus 1.685 kilonewton meter. Likewise, we can calculate all other moments. So finally, MDC. Now we can calculate the reactions RA, RD, HA, HD, because RA, RD, HA and HD are in terms of joint moments. Therefore, now we have the joint moments. Therefore, we can substitute back to get the actual values of RA, RD, HA and HD. So once we have a joint moments, you can easily draw the bending moment diagram as usual. Now we stop here because we have all the values. Okay, we have fully
analyzed the tree with the soil. Okay?